Sometimes there's confusion about the difference between these two functions, as well as how to determine the derivatives of these functions. They're both composite functions, but for this first function here, the exponent of 4 is attached to the entire function natural log x. And this function here, the exponent of 4 is only attached to x. So we will have to apply the chain rule to differentiate both of these functions, and the key is identifying the inner function and letting that equal u. So for this function, the inner function is natural log x, so we'll let u equal natural log x. Therefore, u prime or du dx is going to be 1 divided by x. So now we can think of this function as u to the fourth and apply the extended power rule. So we'd have f prime of x is equal to the derivative of u to the fourth with respect to x, that would be 4 times u to the third, but u is natural log x, times u prime, and u prime is 1 over x. So here our derivative function is going to be equal to 4 times natural log raised to the third power divided by x. Now for our second function, u is going to be equal to x to the fourth. Therefore, du dx, or u prime, is going to be equal to 4x cubed. So when we write this in terms of u, it's going to be natural log u. So now we'll differentiate natural log u with respect to x, and the formula is here. So we'll have f prime of x is equal to 1 over u times u prime, which will be 1 over x to the fourth times 4x to the third, which would be over 1. And now we can simplify 3 factors of x out here. This would simplify to 1, this is simplified to x to the first. So we have f prime of x is equal to 4 divided by x. Now there is one more thing I want to mention about this function here. We could apply the power property of logarithms to this function, but not to the function here on the left. F of x equals natural log x to the fourth is equal to 4 natural log x. So in this form, f prime of x would just be equal to 4 times the derivative of natural log x, which is 1 over x, which does give us the same derivative function of 4 over x, as we see here. But we cannot apply the power property of logarithms to this function here because we're raising the entire function to the fourth power, not just x as we have here. So I hope this example helps clarify the difference between these two functions as well as their derivatives. Next, we'll take a look at an example that requires the product rule.